There's an ongoing discussion about cofactors of vitamin D. That means vitamin K2, vitamin A, and magnesium. Would you comment on that?
Well, magnesium obviously is incredibly important during pregnancy. And the thinking is that it may help especially women that are in eclampsia, but maybe even help to prevent preeclampsia. So magnesium is a very important component. And vitamin A is equally important for overall health and welfare of cells. You can't have too much of it, but you definitely need an adequate amount of vitamin A throughout your life, including during pregnancy.
And the question of vitamin K2?
And vitamin K2, I think certainly it has a role to play. How important it is and whether you're able to get enough from dietary sources, I think continues to be controversial. From my perspective, is that if you have a healthy diet, especially green leafy vegetables, you're probably getting all of the vitamin K that you need. Dr. Sarah Booth is one of the world's experts, has written on this multiple times. There isn't any question that vitamin K plays a role in the gamma carboxylation process of proteins in your bone, as well as, of course, for clotting factors. So yeah, it does have a very important role to play. And if you're not having a healthy diet, then yes, vitamin K2 as a supplement is probably reasonable. But I don't think that it's absolutely required if you have an adequate intake from dietary sources.
But still more, there are people who say if you don't have enough vitamin K2, you're unable to resorb vitamin D in your gut.
In my opinion, that is just not true. There is absolutely no evidence to support that.
Okay, thank you. That's a clear statement.